This is a beautiful camera out of the 1990s, and it's a Pentax Opsio. The type number is, as far as I know, the Opsio E30, and the issue is that this is a very good camera, but it has a real built-in flaw. And that flaw is that it cannot be supplied by, say, two batteries of 1.5 volts, carbon zinc or other types, and also not by nickel cadmium cells. Here, two nickel cadmium cells don't work, and the camera will always give, say, a notion of too low battery, and that's a very important flaw that was attached to this camera. But it's a beautiful camera, and you can also see here that it has 7.1 megapixels. That does not tell us a lot about the quality of the photographs that can be made with this camera. But in those days, say 15 years ago, 20 years ago, this was a very, very good camera. And I have done some adaptations to this camera. At first, my first idea was to make, say, an outboard battery pack with wires into the camera itself, and it didn't work. I don't know why, but anyway, but this is finally a very good way to make this camera usable again, with its beautiful objective, its beautiful lens. And that's visible here. It's a beauty. Anyway, so, well, go to my drawing. That Pentax Opsio, here is the front, and here is the backside, and here is that backside too. And the remedy of it all is that we have to connect not two nickel cadmium batteries here to that camera, but three of them. So that's the way that I did it. Here is the location where the batteries are inserted, but I have, say, soldered here a wire to another nickel cadmium battery, the positive to the negative, and here the positive to the negative. I cannot open it now at the moment because everything will fall apart. And I've also, say, drilled kind of hole here and inserted a pin, a steel nail of a very small diameter that holds the whole circuit together. And I have mounted here, say, a kind of piece of steel or aluminium, I don't know that exactly, that holds that, say, plate that's completely isolated, by the way, here together, so we can, with certain trust, here, that extra nickel cadmium battery. And now it works very, very properly, this camera. Also, the flash works very properly. All the sensors work very properly, etc., etc. Of course, when you do this, you need a charger to charge these, say, 3 nickel cadmium batteries. And here is a very, very primitive charger to charge these batteries. All 1.2 volts, say they are 1800 milliampere. So you need a certain time to charge them, and I will give more information in the text box about the charging time and the voltage. Nickel cadmium batteries are overall usable. They are not very critical when they have to be charged compared to, say, lithium ion batteries. I don't do circuits, charge circuits about lithium ion batteries. They are, in my opinion, too critical. Anyway, these cells are easy to charge. And well, I will demonstrate that camera now. First this. So, well, let's see. The Pentax camera, switch it on now. And now it works properly. When you don't use this extra battery here, you will surely get a message that the battery is too low or depleted or whatever. And of course you can take a picture. Well, of course I'm trying to make a picture now. And it makes that picture properly. And you can also see here on the indication that the battery is charged properly. It has everything to do with this extra nickel cadmium battery. So, switch out the light here, all the lights. Perhaps we can see now that the camera will flash. I hope it will do that. It's dark now. Switch it on. Yes, it flashes. So, also a good, say, amount of energy stored in the battery. To make the camera flash. So, anyway, it's a good thing. A good idea to get such an old camera working again. Well, that was all to tell. And it's a beautiful camera. It works very properly. It makes very good pictures. And also the colors on the pictures are very good. Has, in my opinion, everything to do with all the properties of Pentax. A very good brand that made many, many good cameras, also analog cameras in the past.